The solar industry is very, very focused on improving efficiency and reducing the cost. Our attempt here with this research is to propose a new way of looking at these structures and saying, well, you can use existing materials and nothing really needs to change very much. You just shape them in different ways that gives you this benefit. Kirigami is a Japanese art that's related to origami, where origami is really about folding of things, and kirigami is about cutting things. A colleague of mine who's an artist, Matthew Shlian, he had some interesting new shapes, and when you pulled on the sheet of paper, the cuts would sort of begin to buckle and deform in a very controlled way. And so I realized at that point that we could look at that structure as a hyper-miniaturized version of solar trackers. Conventional solar tracking has been used for many, many years. The mechanism itself costs quite a bit of extra money. What people end up doing is they say, well, since the mechanism is going to cost all this extra money, we might as well put a really big panel. And then eventually you end up with something that's really big and really heavy. When you think about putting this type of thing on a rooftop, it's very, very difficult, and in most cases, it's just purely impossible. It was a fairly lengthy process because the things that you do in paper don't automatically translate to other materials. And so I started talking to my colleague, Steve Forrest, about using some of their very high-efficiency gallium arsenide solar cells. Pretty thin, less than 2 microns thick, and that's 10 to 50 times thinner than the thickness of the human hair. What the new design allows us to do, in contrast to conventional tracking, is that it basically allows us to work with the same form factor. It doesn't catch the wind, it doesn't weigh any more than a conventional solar panel might, and the thing that it buys you is that you can use less semiconductor to gather the same amount of energy, you know, a third less material to generate the same total amount of energy that you would otherwise, which means in turn that I could decrease the cost of installation because there are fewer panels to install. But you do require a little bit of extra area. When you multiply it by the total number of solar installations, it's kind of like a $1 billion value proposition potentially. I guess it looks simple enough, kind of like something that you could do on your kitchen table. Things don't have to be complicated for them to work. If this could be shown to be quite reliable, then the net benefit could be quite big.
These candies, which are already pretty soft, should be about 10 to 100 times stiffer than the silicone. So the material that we're working with in the lab is really, really soft.